गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड सम इनपुट डिवाइसेस दैट आर यूज्ड इन आवर कंप्यूटर। ओके, नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस हाउ कंप्यूटर कैन प्रोसेस द डेटा। ओके, सो व्हाट इज द मेन वर्किंग ऑफ कंप्यूटर? कंप्यूटर टेक्स इनपुट, then it that input will be processed, and after processing it will display the result. So computer can take input from multiple devices that we have studied in our previous class. Now after that input, computer will process the data. Now what the process mean? Process means converting data into information is called process. Now what is difference between data and information? Data is a collection of raw facts and figures which don't have any existence or meaning, but information is more meaningful or more managed than data. Okay, now in general example we can say the raw material can be a wood, and if there is a wood, we cannot do anything from wood. But what carpenter do? Carpenter take that good and convert that good into furniture. So that piece of good is data, and when carpenter convert that piece of good into furniture, then that furniture is known as information. In term of computer, we can say that let us suppose you are searching in Google. We know that Google have a huge amount of database, but you are searching any particular file. So what you will do, you will type anything on search box and click on search button, and then Google search in its whole database and give you a particular file. So that huge amount of database is a data for you, because you don't need the whole data, you need just small piece of information. So that huge amount of data is called data. And after searching that file, that the file that is displaying on your screen is a information for you. I hope it is clear for you. Now there are basically four components: CPU, motherboard, SMPS and memory. First of all, we discuss about the CPU. CPU, we know that CPU is central processing unit, but one thing that I want to tell you, that the box that you see that is connected from your monitor and keyboard, that box is not CPU. That box is called cabinet. Correct. So inside that cabinet box you find CPU. CPU is a very small part inside that cabinet. Sometimes CPU is also called processor or multiprocessor. And the speed of CPU is measured in hertz, or nowadays you can say in gigahertz. Okay. So now there are three basic part of CPU. You will see that block diagram. That is very, very important for your examination purpose. This is your input device. This is your output device. We are giving input to the processor, to the CPU, and CPU is processing that input by using control unit, arithmetic logic unit and memory unit, and after processing it will display the result by using output devices. Okay, so first part of CPU is ALU. ALU stand for arithmetic logic unit. All the arithmetic and logic operation are performed by ALU. Again, I am repeating the definition, or all arithmetic and logic operation are performed by ALU. And you can say the actual processing of our computer, because we are saying CPU is doing what? CPU is processing our data. So who is doing processing? Actual processing is done by ALU. Okay. Now second part is control unit. Control unit, as the name suggests, is controlling. It is controlling our whole computer. It is controlling all the input and output devices, all the resources. Everything is controlled by control unit. Okay, we know that CPU is also called brain of computer. Why it is called brain of computer? Because of control unit. Now students, see, control unit is controlling everything. It is not processing anything. Its work is controlling. Okay, if you want to process anything, so we will process with the help of ALU. And if you want to control it, control anything, then we will control by using control unit. Okay, now see students, in our broad body, brain is a control unit of our body. Brain do not perform anything. Performance work is done by our hand. Okay, but the instruction is given by our brain. Okay, so brain is equivalent to control unit and our hands is equivalent to ALU. Now memory unit, to process the data we need a memory also. And computer, our CPU use RAM and ROM for that purpose. So that we will discuss in our later session, what is RAM and ROM. But right now you just know the what is the meaning of memory unit. Memory unit means RAM and ROM. Computer use RAM and ROM as a memory unit in our system. And what is RAM and ROM, we will discuss in our next class. Okay, so this is all about the processing of our computer. Now after processing, computer CPU gives the result in the form of output devices. There are basically three output devices: monitor, printer and speaker. If you want to see the result in your screen, then you will use monitor. If you want to see your result in term of hard copy or a printed copy, then you will use printer. If you want to listen your output, then you will use speaker. Now monitor is a very basic output device. It is a screen of your computer and it is also called video. Full form is very important. Video means visual display unit. Okay, so that screen is the combination of small tiny rectangular box. That boxes are called pixel. Okay, so pixel is the smallest unit of your screen and resolution is number of pixel of screen can hold is known as pixel. Okay, so I think you have heard about whenever you watch the video on YouTube, you will set the resolution. It can be 360, it can be 480, it can be 720, it can be 1080. So it is a resolution. Resolution means a number of pixel a screen can hold is called resolution. And what is the meaning of pixel? Pixel is the smallest unit of any image or screen, and it is a small tiny rectangular boxes. Okay, so there are basically three types of monitor: CRT, that is called cathode ray tube, LCD, liquid crystal display, and LED, light emitting diode. Among all three, CRT is rarely used nowadays because it is outdated now. But this type of television you have seen on your screen on your childhood. Okay, if you know that, it is a very huge bulky television on your childhood you have seen in at your home. But nowadays this television is replaced by this kind of television that is very slim and it consumes less power than CRT also. Okay, so nowadays CRT is very less popular. You hardly see the CRT monitor nowadays. But nowadays LCD and LED is very popular. Both are useful, both are used according to their purpose. But if we compare LCD and LED, LED have a much better performance than LCD. Picture quality is better in LED and the power consumption is also very good in LED. But if we talk about cost, so LCD monitor is very cheaper than LED monitor. So although LED is best, but LCD monitor have, because it is very cheaper, it is also very popular nowadays. Okay, so this is all about the monitors. Now we will talk about the printer. What is printer? If you want to see the result in term of hard copy or in a printed form, we will use printer. So what printer do? Printer will convert soft copy into hard copy. Okay, so basically there are two types of printer, impact printer and non-impact printer. Impact printer are very noisy, but non-impact printer are less noisy as compared to impact printer. There are two types of impact printer, daisy wheel and dot matrix, and there are three types of non-impact printer, inkjet, thermal and laser. Okay, impact printer are again very rarely used nowadays, but in some places you see the use of dot matrix printer, like your passbook is printed from dot matrix printer, and whenever you take a railway ticket, it is also printed by dot matrix printer. But dot matrix printer are used, but use is very rare. It is very limited. You will see very limited use of dot matrix printer. Nowadays non-impact printer are very popular. Among all three non-impact printer, inkjet, thermal and laser, laser printer have a best quality and speed. Okay, but all three printer are used nowadays. Like if we say inkjet printer, because it is very cheaper than laser printer, that's why it is used nowadays. In your home, you often see the use of inkjet printer. Okay, so although laser printer is best, but it is not very it is not commonly used, because it is very costly. If you want to use your printer at home, you can use inkjet printer. Its quality is good, and but its speed is very less than as compared to laser. But again, for your purpose, you can use inkjet printer. Now next is thermal printer. Thermal printer, you will see your ATM receipt is printed by thermal printer, or if you go in restaurant or shopping mall or for movie, and they will give you a printed bill, so that bill will be printed by a thermal printer. So all three printers have their own use. It depends upon your purpose, which printer you wanna use. Okay, so that's it for today, students. And your next class is on Wednesday. But I think there is one device left. That is speaker. Speaker, you know that. Speaker or headphone. Okay, if you want to see the output in term of sound, you can use speaker. Okay, but I have one question for you. If what is the difference between headphone and earphone? If you know the answer, do give me the answer in the comment box. Okay, so this is done for today, and I am giving you a PDF as well. So note down that PDF in your notebook. Your next class will be on Wednesday. So till Wednesday, complete your work. Thank you, students. If you have any doubt, then you can comment me on that video. Thank you and have a great day.